India. My mind, the key thing is to make India very easy and simple so that young people like you can create wealth, you can innovate, you can do your startups, you can drive India digitally forward, and as you grow and prosper, India will grow and prosper, because in the last 68 years we've made India very complex, very difficult and a very complicated place to do business. So we need to make India very easy and simple, that's one. Secondly, it's important that we become a very innovative society. The West has always innovated. It has innovated for war machines. It has innovated for drones. It has innovated for driverless cars. But India's requirement of innovation is very different. India needs to innovate to make India sewage free. India needs to innovate to provide water which is free from fluoride and arsenic. India needs to innovate to ensure that its farmers are able to get fertilizer and seed based on soil and weather conditions on a real-time basis. We need to innovate so that we can do our flyovers in 40 days rather than 4 years as it takes. And therefore, our requirement is innovation is very different from the rest of the world. And if India is able to innovate and find solutions for its 1 billion people, we will then be able to find solutions for the next 7 billion people who will be moving from poverty to middle class across the world. And therefore, we need to innovate for Indians rather than for the Western world. The Western world has high level of innovation but with very few challenges, whereas our challenges are very many more but with few innovators. But our requirement of challenges are for India's problems. The third key aspect is that we are seeing a lot of energy, vibrancy and dynamism with our young startups. Vast number of startups. We have about close to 19,400 startups. Their valuation is in the region of about 75 billion. But I envisage that by 2023-24, we'll have close to about 100,000 startups with valuation of over close to 500 billion. And it's young companies which create jobs. There's a very famous study by Kaufman for United States which says that actually existing large companies do not create jobs. It's young companies which create jobs, and therefore we need to build this ecosystem for driving more and more startups. We saw some great innovation across several areas, not merely that Flipkart and Snapdeal are taking on Amazon of the world, but the fact that there's one startup in India which is able to teach 9 million Indians how to speak English. Or when the tsunami happened in Chennai, it was not the government of Tamil Nadu which could provide food and shelter to the people, but a young startup called Social Cops, which was able to assist and provide shelter, assist the government of Tamil Nadu to ensure that food packets could reach the people. These are great social innovations. Or look at an innovation like InShots. Many of you would have stopped reading newspapers but take news which is in just 60 words, InShots, has had 5 billion downloads and started by a dropout from IIT Delhi. Or if you look at the world of health, both your Practo, Mitra Biotech, all these are unique innovations which have taken place. These are startups which have enabled cancer care to be done, or in one case, stool management, which is a huge problem. 16 million Indians suffer from it. And we've had a startup inventing an inverter adapter, which is not only accepted by All India Institute of Medical Sciences, not only by Fortis and Escort, but by hospitals across the world. So unique amount of Mitra Biotech, which relocated from Silicon Valley into Bangalore,